Okay, I think based on what just happened today, I think I could definitely talk about how things are going on, but now's not the time to get too worried about what's going on. I just need to take my mind off what's going on. I just, because of, yeah, look, if you can hear my voice, you can already tell the tone of what the video is going to be like and why I'm addressing this the way I am, because yeah, even with what just happened, there's also another, among other things, a reboot of Ben 10 that is currently airing overseas. He is scheduled to come to Cartoon Network in this country, in the US, in 2017. You know what I mean? Before I get too into this, I'm going to have to point out how I may not be the biggest Ben 10 fan. I do kind of appreciate all the concepts it has, and also what they're trying to do with it. But overall, when I was younger, when I was on, I was kind of more of a semi-Jack After the Last Airbender kind of guy. I mean, still kind of am. But this, my word. Because, and even though, as I pointed out before in some of my other videos, that even though I acknowledge the idea of rebooting a series often as a crapshoot, I have to agree, I have to admit the fans have a point in this one, because it's bad. Maybe not as bad as people expect it to be, but still pretty bad. And even though the overall premise is still the same, which I mean, a young man named Ben Tennyson and his cousin Gwen, as well as his grandfather, on a cross-country road trip, he finds this wall challenging army trick and a meteor. It clamps onto him, grants him the abilities of 10 aliens. But in this case, I've heard people complain about the other version of the show before, but I didn't really watch them, and so it didn't really mean anything to me. That's why when they bring up a comparison to a show I actually do watch and like, it doesn't really mean anything. However, in this case, this is definitely going to be the experience of Cartoon Network, how to see the power of fan base, Ace and their nerd rage, made sense. I mean, if you thought people got their shorts now for Teen Titans Go, and the Powerpuff Girls, which admittedly have their audience, and even despite some of the backlash, this show honestly puts those two ones to shame. Because this one meant to take the action and format with a little bit of comedy, and makes it into an 11-minute one, which just off the wall, all cheesy, because made sense. And the designs, while a large selling point in the previous series of how they were heavily influenced by anime tokusatsu, onto this one is decidedly more cartoonish looking. I'm not sure how well that suits Ben 10 voice, because, and that wouldn't mean anything if the designs were a bit better, but to be honest, it's kind of like someone got a hold of their kids' drawings and just decided to animate those, Unless it was how it works since. And I'm not sure how Eric has a friendly, this next part's going to be for Google, but I always think, every time I see Ben or Gwen on screen, I always think they're on something. What's wrong with your face? My blanket impression is getting pretty good there, since it's how you kind of feel, a lot of people do, since. And I understand that even if the previous series were not more originally driven, this one really is trying to put that angle, but in any case, you shouldn't have to sacrifice the quality of storytelling to sell more toys. That's part of the reason why I'm not a fan of Yo-Kai Watch, for instance. That's made sense. If you want to sell merchandise on a show, that's totally fine, but the storytelling has to come first. As I often thought this is a highly counterproductive way of thinking that really needs to stop, man. I mean, you should worry about writing a good story with interesting characters and nice animation first, and then worry about how many toys you can sell and keep a show on the air. I mean, I'm sorry if I come off as kind of heavy in this video. I mean, even addressing something that I normally wouldn't. But I kind of feel it needs to be done in this case, man. Since it's not the first animated reboot they've done that's probably going to make a lot of people unhappy, but this is the first one where even if someone like me who's not a fan of Hannah Fence in general thinks it's really not that great. Hate me because nice. And I have occasionally watched some sporadic episodes of the Hodge original show and online, and even I admit it's I can see why people like it, but in this case, I definitely think sometimes, yeah, I can understand if you need to take things as they come as an anime, but this definitely need a lot more rewrites, man, and redesigns. I mean. And as for the web series thing, I don't think that's really a valid excuse either, because I mean, look at stuff like Stranger Things. Looks like a new Voltron show. I mean, look at a new Inspector Gadget, man. I haven't seen that last one yet, but it looks pretty interesting. I mean, and then also all these DreamWorks shows, I mean, I have not seen any of those ever, but some of them might be pretty good, like the Dragons one. And I don't, and let me make clear that for superheroes, I'm not entirely against redesigning and reimagining characters, given how many versions of things like Batman, Superman, Spider-Man, the X-Men we've had, as well as others like Ninja Turtles and Power Rangers as well. That's because, and even if my usual threshold of 3 or 5 episodes doesn't affect me, there have been 11 they skit so far. New one just came out today, and I'm gonna be using that one as an example because I'm just gonna let you know it did not win me over my initial threshold, and it really hasn't gotten better since then, because I mean, for some reason, he's in Ben is fighting a clockpunk octopus, which can be charity described as like a discount on Technodrome, or Tripunk War of the Worlds, or whatever, because I'm just, and this, also this man who seems to be winning some kind of League of Legends cosplay, whatever. I mean, I don't play that game, but that's what I've been getting from this, because, and for reasons I don't explain very well, on the MS version, Ben, for some reason, is afraid of, we have cephalopods. I mean, to what degree am I supposed to be invested in the young man's fear of cephalopods? Just once. I mean, and that's another thing, because Liberty's taking the characterization also interesting, because I think so go, before I eventually had to just pull the plug on that, my reviews of that series, I mean, I knew fairly early on that I had to approach it with a different mindset than I said I would the original series because of how it's portrayed, but it was clear to me that a lot of people didn't share my enthusiasm for it, so I just pulled a plug on them. Probably do a nostalgic rave on the original series, put them to bed once I get things rolling again. And new Powerpuff Girls, and try to keep an open mind the best I can. I mean, and in that one's defense, even if Craig isn't involved with it, I don't think it's that bad. But I think this one actually is, I mean, in that sense. Again, even if, as someone who's not a big fan of the French as a whole, just everything that's going on this year and what's going to be going on over the next 4 years, just making assumptions about what's going to happen. Yeah, but I just feel that this is definitely, of all, a lot of these anime reboots I've seen lately, this is one of the weakest ones I've seen so far, I mean, since, and I honestly don't care what happens to these guys, I mean, which I don't think it's something the creators wanted to hear. I mean, no sense. And to me, it's a kid show excuse never really been a valid excuse for me, because I was managed to fail both basic litmus tests. As for me, as an adult viewer, because as I mean, it did not fail to appeal to my inner child, and also failed to appeal to me as an adult animation enthusiast. I mean, and I imagine that a lot of other people, as more stuff trickles out, is going to, you know, keep pointing this out as well, since I watched some reviews after skim binging the series easily a few nights ago, and it's even the ones who are trying to be optimistic, I mean, it's kind of mediocre. I mean, since and it's one thing when, you know, you have uncertainty about what's going to happen on a broad level of all over the coming year, but if something a lot of people enjoy is being represented this way, hey, then I can definitely see why people can be angry about that. And all things considered, I mean, once the thing does get stateside, I definitely not sure how it's going to be received, but given how people have been reacting towards the what the leaked episodes of the overseas airings, Cartoon Network has a work cut out for them. Since all the stuff they use in the show, it's been done by the person like I mentioned on the regular show, and can't do another review about those when I was winding down. I just kind of finished watching more of it, man. For comedic aspects, and I personally say if you want good, cartoons from this time period to have a good blend of comedy and action. My personal favorite ones right now, of the newer ones, would have to be and I'm going to be factoring both original properties and some of the reimaginings of his older IPs. If you want to see the show and see a good heavy imagining of this, I would definitely suggest the new Ninja Turtles and Star Wars Rebels, since the former is going to be having a fifth season soon, and I'm getting caught up on that with my DVR. And the third season of Rebels is underway. It's really looking really good. I mean, it's having fanfic of General Throne in there as well, and I think I may be showing a bit of a personal preference given my shirt and the way my set is right now. And for original stuff, I really enjoy Star Wars: The Voice of Evil. Evil main sense. Voice of Mantle Royal series main sense. And also, even though it's not an action show, Milo's Murphy's Law looks pretty fun, and in my opinion, main sense. And as for the Hall of the Hand of the Road Trip premise, main sense, the rust bug is still there. I mean, that's what they call the RV in the one, and I'm caught somewhere between mocking how bad the CGI looks, I mean, given how my 3DS can lose their graphics in it, and also comparing that to Walt Holt and Jesse's RV from Breaking Bad. I mean, so that definitely tells you how well I think about it, and it's just too heady a concept for this format they're going with. And also just comes off the kind of like a poor man's Gravity Falls. I mean, I'm definitely working on rewatching that series from the start, and also be willing to support whatever Alex is going to do next, man. Because no matter what happens with this reboot, which we're going to be facing lots of challenges over the next few years, I'm thinking escapist fiction is going to come in handy, especially in my case, but here I would suggest if you are a fan of the previous Ben 10 series, I would suggest approaching with caution in this case. But if you're not, then I did think just say skip it made sense. But because it's better fair available made sense. Could go watch the Ninja Turtles, go watch Rebels, go watch Star Wars Force of Evil and Evil, Milo movies and all. And just leave this for now. I'm just kind of burnt out right now, guys. Thanks for now. I'll have more content and over the rest of the month. It's 9 days of Pokemon Sun and Moon. Have more videos on that, as well as gonna be addressing both Star Wars Clone Wars movies, as well as having a special surprise around Christmas time because I'm gonna need it. That'll be all for now. Bang.